In this lesson, I'll show you some useful sizing, alignment, and distribution options that work for all objects in Excel. Term objects in Excel refers to things like shapes, pictures, text boxes, and also slicers. Basically, most of the things you can click on and drag around the environment. We'll be positioning the slicers we've made in the correct place on the left sidebar and sizing them appropriately before looking at some of the other options with regards to a slicer's functionality. As an easy way to demonstrate the alignment and sizing techniques, I've drawn some random squares on the screen of different sizes. To do those, I just simply clicked into Insert, Shapes, pick the square, and just drew it on the screen somewhere. Delete that one, we don't want it. You can see immediately that they're all different sizes, and let's say we want to make them all the same size and we want to line them up and have an equal gap between each of them. Let's say the top one is the size we want. We can click on that, go into Shape Format, and on the right here, we've got height and width, and we'll see that it tells us that it's 2.91 high and 7.41 wide. Let's take that 7.41 value and try and apply it to the other squares. Do that, multi-select them by clicking on each of them, then holding control and clicking on each of the others. That selects all of them, and you'll notice that height and width are blank. The reason for that is that each of them has a different height and width, and it can't give us a single value. So let's put in 7.41 as it was, and click Enter. Now they should all be the same size as this one, which was also 7.41. Using the same method, let's set the height to be the same on all of them. Again, let's click on this and get our height, so 2.91, and then click on one of the others and then hold Control and select the other three and type 2.91 and press Enter. We've now got five squares of identical size, but they're not aligned yet and there is not a consistent gap between them. To achieve some alignment in a really easy way without having to try and move them around manually and line them up, which will take you forever and the chances are you won't ever get it perfectly right, just click on each of them while holding the control key to select all of them. Now, in Shape Format again, you can click on Align over here and then Align Center. That brings them all in line with each other. To create an equal gap between them from top to bottom, we make sure that all of them are selected as before. Again, we're in the Shape Format option and then Align. This time we're going to click on Distribute Vertically, which will then distribute those squares from top to bottom, with the highest one being the marker of the top and the lowest one being the marker of the bottom. If I click that, you'll see that it creates a nice equal gap between each of them. Let's use the technique I've just shown you to apply a consistent width to our three slices. We're going to take the width from release year, so this time instead of Shape Format it's Slicer, but the same other options apply. So we click on Slicer and we've got a width of 5.9. We're now going to click on to Position and then hold Control and click Studio and then type 5.9 and hit Enter. At this point we're not going to make the heights match because we don't actually want that in this case. We do want to line them up though centrally, so let's pick all of them this time. So release year, position, studio, click on Slicer, click into Align and then Center. Now they're over to the right at the moment, so we can then use our arrow keys. That would be my suggestion. You can drag and drop them around like this, but using the arrow keys will just give you a little bit of a finer detail, get them in the middle. If we click on an individual slicer, so I'm going to pick release year at the top here and then click on Slicer, you'll see at the top in the menu bar that there's loads of different customization options which are there as a default. Similar to the table, you can pick some standard options here, the look of the slicer in general. What we can also do, which is a bit more useful to us, if for release year, the bars that represent a year, 2016, have a load of white space or a gap to the right of them. We could get all of those dates or years on one line if we use something a little bit creative. So whilst we've got release year selected, at the top here we've got columns and it says one. Let's change that to by selecting in there, hitting three, press enter, you'll now see that it's got them all on one line. Where there's more available options than will fit inside a slicer, Excel will add a scroll bar down the right hand side as it's done here with the position slicer. Now if we were to apply our columns option here and change it to four, which seems about appropriate for the position slicer, that will remove our scroll bar. So just to clear this up, there's nothing actually wrong with scroll bars, but if you can avoid them, then great. That means that in terms of the slicers, we're just clicking once on a slicer and it takes us straight to what we want to see in terms of the view. That improves navigation and the general usability of the file. So any reduction in clicks, which scroll bars obviously add, is a bonus. Using the alignment and sizing techniques I've just showed you, I've managed to get all of the slicers down the left with no scroll bars, which means at the single click of a button, you can filter your data and your table instantly. The last thing I'm going to show you on slicers for now is my suggested visual design. As I stated before, this is totally up to you and just my personal preference, but I think it goes a stage further than the options that are available as default in Excel that you can pick from the slicer option in the top menu bar. So if we click on release here as an example, as I showed you earlier, you've got these options as default. Some of them are quite nice, and depending on the rest of your design, they might fit for you. But for me, I wanted something a bit different, so let me show you how to achieve that. In the next lesson, I'll be showing you some visual customization options for slicers to really take them to the next level, ensuring they seamlessly integrate with all of your future tools.